Hey boy, I got a little chuckle roast down here, and it's a pretty fatty one. It's going to make a good gravy though. It was on sale too, that's why it's fatty. And I got some salt that's white, you can't see it because it's on a white plate, cayenne, onion powder, pepper, thyme, and oregano, and I got some garlic cloves peeled here. I'm going to make a little pockets in that chuck. Mix all these ingredients up and pour these dry ingredients into each pocket, and then top the pocket off, stuff the clove of garlic in the pocket. You can also do the same thing and put a green onion in the pocket and snip it off. My wife said she don't like that non-union. So nothing flying, so she must be out the room. Let me get started. So all these dry ingredients going in this little disposable cup to fill up the landfills with. I'm gonna take a little spoon. Give me a little spoon and mix it up. And as you dry ingredients, kind of like a homemade Cajun hot stuff. So what you do is you make you a pocket, open it up with your finger. Can you see over there, boy? Get some of this, put it in the pocket, put a clove of garlic in there. We're going to brown this down in a pot and make us a Cajun pot roast. No Yankee pot roast here, boy. I got some EVOO in there. And I'm going to put my stuff side down. And if you do it before the pan gets too hot, don't splatter all over you. And you don't look like a fool or a short order cook. I'm also going to put the rest of this rub on this side, which is the other side. See, it's this side, and then there's that side. Go figure. And look, my stove's all dirty again. I just cleaned it a week ago. Dirty again. Imagine that. We cook every day. All right, look like time to flip. Brown the other side. Yeah. You want that. Ain't burning. You don't worry about that. What you call good. Put the pot top on there. Keep it from splattering a little bit, boy. Alright, so we're going to dump some onions in there while y'all wasn't looking or y'all wasn't paying attention. Now we're going to put some wine in there. We're going to thicken it up. I've seen people from New Orleans use a whole fifth of wine when they're doing this. But I ain't from New Orleans. Alright, now when you pour wine in a dish, you don't want a ball of wine. If you ball of wine, you're going to make it bitter. Simmer the wine. Like, look, you see, look, it's on simmer, boy. You boil that wine in there. It's all right for it to sizzle right at first, but don't boil it. And it wasn't a pint of wine, I mean, fifth of wine, that was a lighter. A liter, boy. So we're going to go ahead and cover this with some water, and I'm going to add some, these cute little pieces of cube salt. How about that? For flavor. I gotta put some more water on that. We're gonna cover it. And after it cooks down for a while, I'm gonna put some carrots and potatoes in here. I just gotta go ahead and get tender. It's gonna take that a little bit, a couple hours. Alright boys, so we got some carrots we're going to put down in there. Been cooking for about an hour. You like carrots? Good. We're going to put some more. We'll get them down in a juice. Put a gravy of that potted roast. We're going to cover it. Let it cook for a little while longer. Alright, boy, I got some red potatoes sliced up. cut up, they going in now. See, like that down this year, that was three medium red taters. Get in there, boy. Now, all right, boy. I got six cups of water in there, and some salt. And I'm gonna put 3 cups of rice in there. And over here, this roast beef coming along real good. These carrots are real, real tender. They're excellent, dude. I done tasted one. Now I'm gonna show you a little trick. To thicken up your gravy, put some of that in there. Alright? And that's gonna make your gravy get thick. Gotta make sure you got enough salt in there. How about that? Let that barrel adjust it if you need to. We go from there. So I got some number one CV early June petit pois peas. See that petit pois? Made by Dubon. And these are really good. They sweet. They ain't like them English peas that are bitter and got a crunchy crust. These are soft, tender, little baby peas. First thing you gotta do is open the damn can. See? Look, fresh out the damn can, boy. They smell good too. They're good with bacon and bell pepper and all that, but we ain't got time for all that. Water boiling, 6 cups with salt. And they go in 3 cups of rice. Back to the bowl. And we're going to cover it. Let it go for 20 minutes. You paying attention, boy?